I'm Adeshinu Elegbede. Well, it's nice to be back again to the Elders Forum. Second edition for this year. Tonight, we want to honor one of the veterans. In fact, one of the last of the last. I'm referring to Dr. Victor Abimbola Olaiya. Well, I'm here with my wife and my friend to enjoy old time. They call us old school, but I tell you the type of music we are going to have here, so philosophical, that gets you thinking and make sure that you think about yesterday, relate with today, and plan for tomorrow. With that, you have a better future. Advice for the upcoming Nigerian musicians. Make sure that the music you chunk out is life. Life in the sense that it be very philosophical. Music that move the society forward. That will make sure that we, Nigerians, are together. Thank you very much.
So music, songs of which is written, Rosie Pickett, you know, all around. And I remember that Dr. Olaiya's band actually had a younger group, which included Joe Okafor and Johnny Astro. And they were the ones who were doing all those kind of materials in Dr. Olaiya's band. And that brought us even closer together and gave us the opportunity to get to understudy Dr. Olaiya's music. And we were proud to play some of the songs on our trips and our tours. And the fact that he not only did highlife music, and he also tried to do the things that the younger ones were doing at the time, shows the versatility of the man. And he was not ashamed to do that. Yeah, as a matter of fact, he added value to such materials at the time. That's one story. The other story I would like to tell was, many years ago when I was an artist manager at Sony Music, we wanted to do one of Dr. Olaiya's songs. We wanted one of the artists to cover one of his songs, a song that this gentleman just sang. The artist's name was Lieutenant Shotgun. And he was going to do a ragga version of that song. I don't know if anybody had the song but remember it. We went to him to ask for his permission, which was the normal thing to do. You don't just take a man's song and record it. We needed his approval and his permission. And we went to seek his permission at the time. And he was so easy about it. He was so easy, just easy about it. He said, okay, and we did the song. After we did the song, before it was released, we went back to him to ask him to listen to it. And he gave his blessing. That was a hallmark of an elder musician, one who appreciated even the young ones doing his stuff. And that's another story. Another story I would like to tell was in the days when we were doing the Musicians Union, particularly PIMA. You know, in the olden days they had what they called Musicians Union, which had many big Nigerian musicians, most of them. The likes of Chris Angelo, Bobby Benson, and all of them, Bobby Benson. And we started this new union, and we went to ask for his blessing. Because at that time, the Musicians Union was no longer stable. But we wanted a strong Nigerian Musicians Union. And we went to ask for his blessing. He also gave his blessing. And that's the hallmark of a man that won progress for musicians and for the industry in Nigeria. I think you should give him a round of applause. So, you know, I can go on and on. I just like to share that because we're talking about a man who has taken Nigeria higher than, many others, particularly in the music. I remember that he played when the Queen was here in the 1950s. Along with the late Bobby Benson and Chris Angelo. And that's how we started. Up till today, the man is still alive and kicking. I bet that if he was here tonight, he would be on stage and blowing his trumpet. That's how strong he is. I want to thank God for his life. I understand that he's not coming here this evening, but we can never forget, you know, I mean, we just had a beautiful song, one of the beautiful songs in the UK. And there are many. Yejemila is there. Aigana, Alright, so I want to thank God for his life. I wish him many more years of good health. I know he's getting older and he's a little frail now, but I know that the Lord will be with him and he will spend the rest of life in good, in joy and happiness. Thank you very much.
I don't belong to the academia, but there's one song that I do, and every time I do it at Stadium Hotel, my bills are picked up by the house. Dr. Rory said, "Don't worry." The first time I did that, I know the man was saying, "Tiny boy," and thereafter I felt it was okay. It was a nod, and I'm so happy. The man is a big inspiration to me. Let's go.